Hello everyone, myself Dr. M.SRUJAN Kumar Reddy. My education background is pharmacy. Today's topic is the water in you, water and human body. We know that water is important for our human body, but we don't know how many liters of water that is present in our human body. And if you consider total constituents present in the human body as 100%, how much percentage of water will contribute to the total constituents that are present in the human body? Let us know all these things with the upcoming slides. First, before going on to the main topic, to know how many liters present in the human body, first we will know the importance of water for your human body. There are some of the importance of water intake. Water will helps you to form saliva, that helps you to digestion, needed by the brain to manufacture hormones and neurotransmitters, keeps mucosal membranes moist, regulates body temperature like sweating and respiration, allows body cells to grow, reproduce and survive, acts as a shock absorber for brain and spinal cord, flushes body waste mainly in urine, converts food to components needed for survival, that is digestion, lubricates joint. Water is the major component of most body parts, helps deliver oxygen all over the body. These are some of the advantages of intake of water in human body. Let us go on to the main topic. The 70 kg standard male contains 42 liters of water, that constitutes about 60% of its body weight. So out of 100%, 60% of its body weight will be constituted with water. So the hypothetical adult female contains 55% of her body weight as water, this lower percent being due to a higher fat content in females. The difference of water percentage in male and females, when compared to male and female, female will be having less percentage. The reason is due to higher fat content. I have depicted a figure here. These figures contain some standard values which are quoted frequently, and these values have been taken on average values. If you can see the image, infants, the water constituents is about 70%, adults it's about 60%, everything is corresponding to its body weight. Okay, elderly person it is 50 to 55%. If you can see, out of 100% constituents that are present in the body, 60% will be contributed to liquid, that is nothing but called as your water. Out of that, 16% will be contributed to fat, and 18% will be contributed to proteins, and 6% will be contributed to the minerals. Okay, so these are your standard values and average values. Here, when you say 60%, how it is distributed in your body? So the total volume of water is 42 liters, that is nothing but 60% of body weight. Now I am considering these values, particular distribution of water, it has been taken as an example as 70 kgs adult man. Okay, these particular values have been given according to 70 kg adult man. Okay, we will see the distribution of water. So these 42 liters has been distributed into two: intracellular fluid compartment, which constitutes about 28 liters, extracellular fluid compartment, which constitutes about 14 liters. And these extracellular fluid compartment again divided into two: intravascular fluid and extravascular fluid. Intravascular fluid, that is nothing but plasma, which constitutes about 3 liters, and extravascular fluid, which is 11 liters. And this extravascular fluid, again it is classified into two, that is interstitial fluid and transcellular fluid. Interstitial fluid, which contribute about 10.5 liters, and transcellular fluid, which contribute about 0.5 liters. Okay, next. Next. So we said some terminologies like intracellular fluid, extracellular fluid, interstitial fluid, intravascular fluid, extravascular fluid. What are these terminologies? Can you see the blood vessel here? Okay, so inside which you have a red blood cell. First, we will just differentiate what are these fluids exhaled. So this is nothing but, the first one is nothing but intracellular fluid. Okay, the cell fluid is nothing but called as intracellular fluid. Okay, and intracellular and interstitial fluid are separated by cell membrane. Intracellular and interstitial fluid separated by a cell membrane. Okay, and can you see plasma? Can you see the plasma? Yeah. Can you see interstitial fluid? Your intracellular fluid, okay, that is present inside your cell, and interstitial fluid surrounding your intracellular, surrounding your intracellular fluid is separated by a cell membrane. Okay, next, plasma and your interstitial fluid both will constitute your extracellular fluid. If you can see the previous slide as a reference, plasma and interstitial fluid will consider as a compartments for your extracellular fluid. Okay, your interstitial fluid and plasma, your interstitial fluid and your plasma are separated by the walls of blood vessel. Okay, can you see the interstitial fluid depicted here? Can you see the plasma which is inside? Your plasma and interstitial fluid are separated by the walls of the blood vessel. So water can move between compartment by osmosis or in response to pressure differences. So this is the depicted picture to explain about this different types of compartments. Okay, your extracellular fluid compartment, intracellular fluid compartment, what is interstitial fluid, what is plasma and all. Okay, are you clear with the concept? Yeah, here we'll go for body fluid compartments composition in detail for a standard 70 kg male. Okay, all these values which are given are standard values and these are hypothetical values taken from different reference texts. Okay, so these are the compartments on the left hand side. You can see extracellular fluid, plasma, interstitial fluid, transcellular, intracellular fluid. Okay, so first we will see what is the contribution of each compartment in liters. Okay, so extracellular fluid which consists about 14 liters, plasma which consists about 3 liters of water, interstitial fluid which consists about 10.5 liters, transcellular 0.5 liters, intracellular fluid 28 liters and total body water 42 liters. Okay, now we will see the contribution in percentages for each compartment. So 33.3% for extracellular fluid, 7.1% for plasma, 25.1% for interstitial fluid, 1.1% for transcellular, 66.6% for intracellular fluid. So this is the percentage body water, 100%. Okay, total body water is 100% corresponding to 42 liters. Okay, now coming to the percentage body weight. So 60% is the total water which contribute to 100% of your body weight. Okay, in this each compartment, what is the percentage? Okay, contribution of each compartment towards the percentage, 19.98% for extracellular compartment, 4.26% for plasma compartment, 15.06% for interstitial fluid compartment, 0.66% for transcellular compartment and 39.96% for intracellular fluid compartment. So 60% of water will be contributed on total body weight. Okay, yeah, coming to the next slide, it is very important and interesting. So as we said that blood consists about 7%, that is nothing but 3 liters. So here, leave about the volume in liters, we will talk about the percentages. As we said, blood consists about 7%. Okay, when you say percentage by body weight, if you consider 100% body weight, in that blood will consist about 7%. Other fluids and tissues will consist about 92 to 93%. So how this blood 7% has been distributed now? So percentage by volume, blood again divided into two compartments. One is plasma compartment. The next one is formed elements compartment. Plasma which consists about 55% and formed elements which consists about 45%. Again, plasma will be divided into three compartments. So plasma percentage by weight, three compartments what? Proteins. Plasma contains proteins, water, other solutes. Proteins will contribute about 7%, water will contribute about 91% and other solutes will contribute about 2%. And when you go for formed elements, that is contributed about 45% is there, right? Again, it is divided into 3. So platelets 250 to 400,000, WBC 5 to 9,000, RBC 4.2 to 6.2 million. These are nothing but formed elements number per cubic mm. It has been given as number per cubic mm. So here when you talk about that, plasma is again divided into 3 compartments: proteins, water and other solutes, and proteins in turn divided into 3. So there are 3 types of proteins present: albumins, globulins and fibrinogen. So albumins will contribute about 58%, globulins will contribute about 38%, fibrinogen will contribute about 4%. When you talk about other solutes, so other solutes, the solutes contribute about 2%. What are the 2% solutes present? Ions, nutrients, waste products, gases and regulatory substances. So here if you see formed elements, it is divided into 3: platelets, WBC and RBC. Again, WBC again in turn, it is divided into 5 types. So neutrophils, that contribute about 60 to 70%, lymphocytes that contribute about 20 to 25%, monocytes that contribute about 3 to 8%, eosinophils that contribute about 2 to 4%, basophils that contribute about 0.5 to 1%. This particular distribution of blood towards the different compartments and the percentages for each compartment and their divisions are very important for competitive examinations, and very important a particular person studying in depth about the water content in blood. Okay. Yeah, coming to the standard formula for calculating total body water for male. Okay, the formula is given as 2.447 minus 0.09156 into age plus 0.1074 into height plus 0.3362 into weight. Here water should be taken in liters into consideration, age should be taken in years, height in centimeters and weight in kg. If you can substitute the required values into this particular formula, you can found what is the total body water for male. Clear? Yeah, next we'll go on to total body water, a standard formula for calculating in female, that is minus 2.097 plus 0.1069 into height plus 0.2466 into weight. So water should be taken in liters, height in centimeters and weight in kg. This formula will give you for calculating total body water in female. So that's all about today's presentation. So thousands have lived without love, not one without water. This is a quotation given for people who don't drink water. Okay, please have increased intake of water. Thank you very much. Please subscribe to my channel. Thank you once again.